Hello and welcome to the new topic, Lexical Semantics. Lexical semantics is of many types: synonymy, antonymy, hypernym, hyponymy, metonymy, polysemy. We move on to the next. Synonymy, sometimes we also call it synonym. The semantic relation that expresses the same meaning between two words. Or in other words, we can say sameness of meaning. Examples: beautiful, attractive, create, make, happy, joyful, true, correct, false, wrong. What we get is that almost we have the identical meaning, sameness of meaning between the two words. And this is what is referred to as synonymy. We have the next, antonymy. Sometimes we also call it antonym. An antonym is a word having a meaning opposite to that of another word. Examples: hot, cold, short, tall, black, white, night, day. So what we get is that we have two contradictory words. They are opposite to each other, as reflected in these examples. And they are referred as antonymy. We move on to the next. Hypernym. A hypernym is a word with a general meaning that has basically the same meaning of a more specific word. Examples: apple, tree, tennis, sport, dog, animal, green, color. What here it refers to is that, so apple is a more specific word, but it refers to as general meaning that it's a tree. Likewise, we have these examples. Tennis is a more specific word, but it is referred to as a sport in general. Dog is a more specific word, a kind of animal, and it refers to in more general way, that is to say animal. Likewise, green and color. And such examples are referred to as hypernym. Move on to the next. Hyponymy, a word whose meaning is included in the meaning of another word. Examples: male, man. The meaning of man, or the word man, is included in the concept of male. Likewise, tree, apple, color, green, sport, tennis, animal, dog. So what we find is that the meaning is reflected in the meaning of another word. We move on to the next. Difference between hypernym and hyponymy. So hypernym is color, and it is in general, color is general, and then we have more specific: purple, red, blue, green. Now further, purple color can have a specific shade of color, that is crimson, violet, lavender. So like this, red, blue, we can say cohyponyms, or blue green we can say cohyponyms, or purple red we can say cohyponyms. And purple further has many shades of color, so we can say that it has many other branches, cohyponyms of purple. Move on to the next. Difference between hypernym and hyponymy. Further examples. So hypernym, you have food, that is the word in general, but we come down to the more specific word, like we have fruit, we have meat, we have vegetable. And further, fruit, like cohyponyms, can have banana, mango, can have banana, apple. Likewise, we can have cohyponyms of meat, we can have beef or chicken. We move on to the next. Metonymy. Metonymy is a figure of a speech in which an object or idea is referred to by the name of something closely associated with it, as opposed to by its own name. Examples: referring to the President of the United States or their administration as the White House or the Oval Office. So what metonymy is that? It's a figure of a speech in which an object is referred to by the name of something. We don't directly call that object by its original name, but the name that is implied, that is symbolic. For example, the office of the President of the United States, particularly in the field of journalism, we call the White House or the Oval Office. And we understand this office belongs to the President of the United States. Likewise, referring to the American technology industry, we refer to as Silicon Valley. 3, referring to the American film industry as Hollywood, referring to the Indian film industry or celebrity culture as Bollywood. We move on to the next, polysemy. When a symbol, word or phrase means many different things, that is called polysemy. Examples: get, it may have the meaning receive, it may also have the meaning reach, it may also have the meaning understand. So the word is one, but the meaning is different. This kind of word is known as polysemy. Take another example, crane, it's a bird. Crane is also construction equipment, so it has here two meanings. Fair is beautiful. Fair also referred to market. Fix, attach. Fix also means repair. Light, a non-heavy object, very light, not very heavy. Light, what the sun gives off. So what we come to know that the word is the same, but it has many different meanings, and that is called polysemy. Hope you understand the lesson. Thank you and goodbye.